tonight is the night. I'm gonna make it happen, finishing an album that I started 2 years ago.
That's right. What was it? 2 years. Probably roughly right around this time, 2011. I was thinking about it, and I made an album called 9/11 the Album, and I'm gonna complete it tonight. I just finished the bass track of a song that I'll make tonight called The 9/11 of Your Heart. I don't have lyrics for it. I'll try and write them later today. Good. Good shit, man. I am, believe it or not, and I, you know, this might be wishful thinking a little bit, but I want to get half of the written pieces of the AA project done tonight. Now, if you tune into this show for the existential musing, stay tuned. We'll have some of those. This is Drive Time, by the way, episode 14B for March the 20th, 2013. It's 12:54 Eastern Standard Time in my neck of the woods, which happens to be New Jersey, United States of America. Thanks for tuning in. This is a show where I talk about projects that I'm working on and fill you in a little bit about my life as I drive to and from my place of business. I'm a businessman. I am a birds of prey enthusiast. I can name and spot pretty much every species that is prevalent in this state of New Jersey. Be it your ospreys, your red-tailed hawks, your garden variety turkey vulture, that sort of thing. Any member of the raptor family, I am pretty well versed in, or at least I'm able to recognize them in nature. And I'm not a nature guy. I hate camping, but I love animals, and I love shows, survival shows, like Survivor Man. I'll watch any of those shows. Survivor Man's probably the best. Les Stroud. Man vs. Wild, I never really was on that fad. It always seemed a little bit just too outrageous for me. He was a little bit, like, too loud. Like, tone it down, man. You're possibly dying, in the wilderness. The Survivor Man strikes a pretty good balance between, hey, I'm on a TV show, and I gotta, this is kind of fucking fucked up, I could die out here. It's a little more real. I mean, it's definitely more real, right, because there's no camera crew, it's just him. And then there's another really dumb one, that's a new one, that's called Dual Survivor, that has these two, one's kind of a hippie, and then there's like an ex-Navy SEAL, but they're both, like, so just giving the yin and the yang of survival. I like that one, too. I really do. I'm wearing two shoes. My foot hurts. It's bad. It's really bad. I don't know if I should ice it or, it's difficult to walk. Sucks. But what I'm going to do today is I'm going to cut out of work as early as possible. And I'm going to go right for a nice sunny, hopefully we'll still have some sun shining. I'm gonna take my dog on a nice long walk. That's gonna be it for me. I'm gonna lay off the running and get to work on this music and some other stuff. Just this weird almost two week period. It's just in a blink of an eye is now over. Where I've been kind of living in a solitary life. I haven't seen any of my friends. My wife has been away. It's been weird. It's definitely something that takes some getting used to. But even now, just only 12 days total was gonna be, but just 10 days. Oh my god, what the fuck is this? It's like some sort of Mad Max thing. It's almost like they're doing road construction, like something, there's like a fire going on. I don't even know what the hell's going on down that street. I don't usually go that way. Oh, that was crazy. I think they were like digging up a pipe or something and there was flames bursting out of the sky. There's cops everywhere. I didn't want to take my camera out and start filming. Safety first. Sometimes I wonder, like, when I'm at work and they're like, if anyone comes in, like, what are you doing? Are you busy right now? And they want to see what I was working on. So like, I just realized I hadn't, for like weeks, would have never had an excuse. And today I like, pulled up something and be like, oh yeah, this. Well, just to have somewhere on my desktop, something. It's gotten to that point. It's really, it's confusing to me how, or what, like, you know, I'll do some work today in the afternoon. It's just, I don't talk about that stuff. I went a different way this time, and I feel it was much faster. I'll look at the clock when I pull into my driveway, which is in a matter of moments. I always go the other way. I should go that way more. I feel like that way just gets me home quicker. Could be wrong. I don't know what my need is. You know, you know what it is? It's difficult to do work and eat. So, like, I always think, like, use your time, get your lunch together, and then go start to get some work done on lunch, your lunch break. You use every second of the day, God forbid. You just can't. You can't. You're using your hands to eat. There's not much else you can really do. That's how that works.